Hello dear students, today we are starting with our new topic on super finishing processes. So some of these super finishing processes we have already studied and some of them are remaining with the discussion. So today we are considering two super finishing processes. First super finishing process is called as galvanizing, and second super finishing process is called as this electroplating. So first of all, we are going to see what is the meaning of electroplating. As you all know, what is the meaning of electroplating? There is one cathode, one anode, and certain solvent is used in order to deposit the anode with the cathode material. So electroplating is the process that uses electric current to reduce dissolved metal cations so that they form a thin coherent metal coating on an electrode. So as we have discussed earlier, what is electroplating? It uses electric current. So very small amount of electric current, around 12 to 24 volts, is used here to reduce dissolved metal cations. Cations means those who are part of the cathode are called as cations. So we are going to dissolve those cations, and then what we are going to do, we are going to deposit that cations on the anode. So that's why this particular electroplating process is also termed as anodizing method. So anodizing and electroplating methods are same. The term is also used for electrical oxidation of anions onto a solid substrate, as in the formation silver chloride on silver wire to make silver or silver chloride electrodes. Third point, electroplating is primarily used to change the surface properties of an object, for example abrasion and wear resistance, corrosion protection, lubricity, aesthetic qualities, etc. So why we are performing electroplating? For improving all these qualities, that is abrasion and wear resistance, corrosion protection, lubricity means in order to achieve a high lubrication on the surface, and aesthetic quality. So this aesthetic quality parameter is more important here, as we are doing electroplating for improving the surface finish or the surface roughness quality, but may also be used to build up thickness and undersized parts or to form objects by electroforming. So it is also used to build certain thickness on the undersized part or objects by electroforming. Electroforming means nothing but we are using one form tool. For example, I am drawing one diagram over here using this pen. For example, one form tool is used. Suppose this is the workpiece on which I have to perform this electroforming. So exactly this form of recess will be made by using the electrolytic operations. So what we are doing here, we are asking the material from this cathode to get deposited on this anode. So that is called as electroforming process. Okay, the process used in electroplating is called as electrodeposition. Electrodeposition means depositing of cations on anode. The part to be plated is the cathode of the circuit. So whatever we want to plate on the surface, that we have to keep as anode, that is the negatively charged electrode. In one technique, the anode is made of metal to be planted on the part. Okay, and the anode is made up of the metal to be planted on the part. So let us study the process of electroplating or electrodeposition. The cations associated with the anions in the solution, these cations are reduced at the cathode to deposit in the metallic zero valence state. For example, for copper plating in an acid solution, copper is oxidized at the anode to Cu2+ by losing 2 electrons. The Cu2+ associates with the anion SO42 and in the solution to form the copper sulfate. Now at the cathode, the Cu2 plus is reduced to metallic copper by gaining 2 electrons. The result of the effective transfer of copper from the anode surface to a plate covering the cathode. The plating is most commonly a single metallic element, or it is not an alloy. So this is the standard copper electroplating machine for layering of the PCBs that is being used here, that is being shown over in this diagram. So electrochemical deposition is generally used for growth of metals and conducting metal oxides because of the following advantages. Why we are performing electrochemical decomposition? The thickness of morphology of the nanostructure can be precisely controlled by adjusting the electrochemical parameters. Relatively uniform and compact deposition can be synthesized in template based structure, and higher deposition rates are obtained, and the equipment is inexpensive due to the non-requirement of the either a high vacuum or a high reaction temperature. So neither a high reaction temperature is used nor the vacuum is required over here. What is required? Just a electric supply and one solvent solution. Okay, so these are the advantages of electrochemical decomposition deposition. Now another method, next method, it is called as galvanizing. Galvanizing is basically of 2 to 3 types. Here we are going to study only the galvanizing process which is widely used in industry, which is called as hot galvanizing. So this slide shows you various steps while we are performing the galvanizing process. First is degreasing. Degreasing means whatever part I have to galvanize, you can see over here, this is the part I have to galvanize. You have to remove all the grease or oil that is on the surface of that particular workpiece. Then rinsing. Rinsing means after degreasing, this is one type of solvent which is used to, or a certain soda type solution which is used for degreasing. Then in rinsing, what we are doing? We are cleaning the surface with the help of clear water. Then pickling. Pickling is done in order to obtain a surface with certain type of solvent, then again rinsing it. Then the flux solution. The flux solution is the hot solution, the solution of which the coating is required on the surface, that is called as the flux solution. Then drying in air for some time. Then zinc bath. Zinc bath gives it the final coating of the zinc on the part. Cooling and then inspection. These are the steps of standard steps of the galvanizing process. So let us see in detail. Chemically clean items are galvanized by full immersion in the molten zinc. So galvanizing process is mainly used to coat zinc on the material. Preparation of the casting for galvanizing. The first requirement is to remove oils and grease and old paint coatings. This is normally done in hot strong alkali solution. If scale, rust and other surfaces contaminants are present, abrasive blasting may be necessary. Abrasive blasting is required for removing the scales. Abrasive blasting is nothing but a process in which we are forcing the abrasive from a nozzle onto the surface, and this force is applied by certain carrier fluids such as compressed air. Okay. Otherwise, these contaminants are removed by acid cleaning or pickling in sulfuric or hydrolic acid. So this can also be removed by pickling followed by rinsing. Hydrochloric acid is preferred because it is more easily reclaimed. Reclaimed means we can again get back hydrochloric acid after the cleaning operation. Iron and steel casting are usually abrasive blast cleaned followed by a brief acid dip. In some circumstances, items may be cleaned electrolytically to remove the foundry sand and the surface carbon. So second step is fluxing. Before a component can be offered to the hot zinc bath, all moisture must be dried from the surface and other cavities. The surface of an acid cleaned steel is very active and will oxidize rapidly more quickly than the surface can be dried. The metallurgical reaction between the molten zinc and the steel surface will not occur if oxides are present on the steel surface. So that's why we are performing the fluxing in order to remove all the moisture from the surface of the workpiece. To prevent this oxidation, the chemically clean, highly active steel surface is immersed in a flux solution, usually 30% zinc ammonium chloride with wetting agents maintained about 65 degrees Celsius. Then applying the galvanized coating, the galvanized reaction takes place between 445 to 465 degrees centigrade. When the dried steel part is immersed in the galvanizing bath, the steel surface is wetted by the molten zinc and reacts to form a series of zinc iron alloy layers. The work remains in the bath until the temperature reaches that to the molten zinc, so that all the galvanizing reactions can go to completion. After the surface of the molten zinc is skimmed to remove the dross from the surface, the job is withdrawn from the bath at a controlled rate. When the surplus surface metal has drained off, the item is either air quenched or quenched in water coating. Then quenching. So the quenching operation is performed in order to quench this galvanized zinc onto the surface. This is the final step. The galvanized zinc surface is highly reactive. It will oxidize rapidly in moist air, and white corrosive products form rapidly when two zinc surfaces are stacked on each other. So that's why they are to be separated with each other. We have to maintain certain distance between the workpieces. To delay this corrosion, galvanizers normally water quench at items in a solution of a potassium dichromate, which applies a chromate film to the zinc surface. The chromate film formed from the dichromate solution is not suitable for powder coating. If the item is to be powder coated, the galvanizer should air quench the item after galvanizing. To prevent the generation of the corrosion products before powder coating, it is essential that the powder coating be applied with a few hours of the galvanizing. If this is not possible, then a light acid etch followed by a zinc phosphate or chromate conversion coating is mandatory. Okay. Then what are the advantages of this hot dip galvanizing? Hot dip galvanizing is a cheaper in long run. It has less maintenance costs. It is environmental friendly. It is completely reliable and protects the steel from rusting, and smooth and uniform coating. So this is our area of concern, that we will be getting a smooth and uniform coating onto the surface. These are the applications: roofing and walling, safety barriers, handrails, consumer appliances, automotive mobile parts. So all the bridges, the cast iron bars used on bridges are galvanized. You must have seen on the highways the barriers which are used to safety barriers which are used at the corner of the road. They are also made up of the galvanized steel. Okay. Then in automobile parts also, you are using many parts which are galvanized. Okay. You have seen such type of the fitments for roofing and walling also, which are the galvanized steel. So these are the wide area of application that is used for the galvanized type of the products. Okay. So this is all about these two processes that we have discussed today. So first process was our electroplating, and second process is our hot galvanizing. So these are the references that I have used to gather the material that is available in this slide. And we will see the last method of powder coating in the part 4 of this video. So thank you very much, and let us learn very hard. Thank you.